Hey everybody, it's Shane over at Matrix Personalized Fitness. I'm shooting another video for you today because I put out a blog yesterday that I sent out to everybody in email as well as on social media posts. This blog was all about breathing. Now I've done other videos on breathing, so I'm not going to rehash what I've already talked about, but I did want to go into exactly some of the skills that I discussed within the blog. The first one is the basic belly breath that I have discussed in other videos. But I've recently learned another neat little technique for it, a little tweak to the way it's been done before. So previously I've taught hand on chest, hand on belly, really try to focus on using the lower hand. I found a much easier way to do this is to focus on the exhales first. And this is how I just give you directions of doing this within the blog. So what you would do is you take a nice, long exhale, really contracting the belly, trying to force a bunch of air out. As you do that, it's going to force all the air out, and then when you're ready to fill in again, it happens naturally. You're not trying to work really hard to breathe in. It looks a lot like this. So when you take that breath back in, chances are your diaphragm is going to do the work that it's supposed to do. A lot of times when people try to take deep breaths, they actually go directly into the upper chest, which is the opposite of what you're looking for when you're belly breathing. So as I mentioned in the blog, think about exhaling first so that when you breathe back in, it happens naturally, and then you can really feel the movement happen in the belly. Now, to something that I haven't discussed before is belly breathing will allow us to tone down our fight or flight sympathetic nervous system. Sometimes we might want to ramp it up. If we're getting tired at work, it's after lunch, we want to wake ourselves up a little bit more. Maybe we're getting amped up for an event or a sport we're going to play. So the way you would do this breathing is to be very fast and rapid about it. It's called Kapalabhati breathing, if you've ever taken yoga and heard of that before. But it's a very rapid exhale and inhale, and it's forceful as well. They call it the skull cleansing breath. So you might need a tissue if you're giving this one a try. It looks a little bit something like this. We exhale quick, inhale quick. If you start that way, that'll help you use up the tissue if you need to, but that's a little bit slower than you want to go. Once you have the feeling behind it, you can start to pick up the pace. As you can see, that was very quick, very rapid breath. It might also really get your belly pumping in and out, which is going to help wake up your entire system as you get all that air flowing through you very quickly. That type of breathing happens naturally when we're getting really stressed out. It might even go to the point of causing hyperventilation. So bringing that up, do make sure that as you're doing and practicing any of these breathing techniques, that you take the time and go slowly into them so that you don't end up hyperventilating and getting yourself a little bit dizzy. It might help to have a chair nearby as well. So those are some of the techniques I talked about in this blog. I hope you find that helpful. If you have any questions, please feel free to post them down below here. And I'll be checking back in next week with some more information for you. Take care.